but I'll tell you my name because it's on the screen. I'm Kevin Pereira.
I'm Candace Bailey. We're coming to you live from the G4 studios in Los Angeles.
Oh, guess what's on the show today?
What?
Go ahead, I'll give you a minute. Wrong.
Bunch of idiots.
On the show today, Sarah Sangwin Carter from TNT's Falling Skies will be here live in studio, hopefully with some helpful tips on surviving an alien invasion, because it's probably going to happen pretty soon.
Probably.
I think so. And Chris Hardwick drops by for some gadget prawn fun. Get your magnifying glasses. The HP Veer is the smallest phone we've ever reviewed. How small is it? Oh, that was the line they were supposed to yell. I'm sorry.
Plus, Jessica Chobot continues playing with the toys in Microsoft's test lab, including a Kinect-controlled helicopter and a telescope that lets you explore galaxies. And we'll catch up on the latest DLC, including a new case for L.A. Noire, when Adam Sessler drops by for a game break.
Sounds like an all right show.
I think it's going to be a good show.
I've watched.
Time now to run down the top five things on the web.
Wanna go around the net?
Yeah.
Okay. The robot was malfunctioning there.
No, you were doing this, and I was
foreshadowing our number five clip, by the way. These aren't your average everyday pistol fingers. These are deep.
Very good.
Thank you.
The Old West was a time when true men were incredibly tough and manly.
Yeah. Right. There we go. Third time's a charm. So that is true, but present day cowboys, like the guy in our number five video, they kind of have a tough time living up to that.
Just shot myself.
Oh, at least scream yeehaw or something.
Look, we have said this over and over again. Wearing the cowboy hat does not give you cowboy powers. I can't even count how many times I've said
it quite often. Remember, kids, only experience can teach you how to quick draw a gun or visit a brothel. These are cowboy skills. So start practicing now while you're younger. In fact, mash them up. Take a gun out at a whorehouse.
No,
it's really the best.
Kevin.
It's the best. They'll let you use it. They'll let you use it. It's going to cost extra.
You should not be saying things like that.
And make sure you clean the barrel.
You are gross. Yeah. Disgusting. In at number four today, a video of a big hairy guy just hanging out and keeping it real.
It's not gay porn, don't worry.
Nyt se pintti näyttää. Sinä sanoit, että... Ootko nää poika koskaan nähnyt, kun... Rottweileri syö majoneesia.
Just a dude eating his morning Activia.
Was he eating?
Hanging out in the forest.
Was he eating mayonnaise?
You'd better hope it was mayonnaise.
The internet is fired!
And rehired. I like that guy. He's my new friend. In at number three today, apathy at the gas pump.
With fuel prices... Sorry. With fuel prices so... It was another
She's
fuzzy.
On crystal meth. We're sorry. That's okay.
It happens every now and then. There was a fuzzy that was coming by.
I thought you thought the condors were attacking or something. Grab a spear!
Is that me?
Yes, that was you.
Wonderful. With fuel prices, third time's a charm.
Can we get her some Activia? No?
Stop it! Gross! So damn high, I guess nothing surprises people anymore. people cared about what was happening.
Yeah, in case you missed all that, a lot of people were focused on the truck and not the apathy in front of it. let's bring out the trusty Telestrator.
Yes!
I'll just show... We'll show everybody in this video not caring as hard as they can. Thank you for that graceful push. So I was actually going to write on the screen. All right, so clearly by the text and the fact that the car is on its side, we know this is probably in Russia. Actually, on Russian SUVs, they put the gas cap right here on the top. So this is actually how you pull up to it. This guy is coming here just to ask if he's tweeting about the incident, not to care at all about what's happening in the truck, and that is someone trying to escape with their life. This guy comes up to just sort of do bro. And then he's gonna walk back away after dude broding. No one can care. There's no one.
No
dude,
one.
You
it's
tell
ridiculous.
Me what I'm missing here. No one cares about the fact that a truck is on the
look.
Side. What, this guy here?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's sad. It's Russia. What are you gonna do?
That is a whole lot of not care.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, now you moved. Go ahead. No, no, no. Read the prompter. We're all friends here. Those were cat
those
ears.
Those are not cat
those
ears.
Those were absolutely cat ears.
Today's number two is a fine example of ragdoll physics in real life. Flying on a bicycle should be left to the professionals, X Games, athletes,
yeah, the tiny
and
hat.
ET. Thank you.
This your hat is tiny.
This is real pretty.
She's going.
Oh, my God.
Got it.
Are you all right?
No, I'm good.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
By the way, that right there?
Yeah.
Good enough to get you a gold medal at the female X Games. That's what that was. I'm telling you.
By the fact that those guys did not even move.
I know. Kudos to them. They kept a cool head. They continued to record. Didn't shake the camera. That's good. That's good for around the net. Good job, boys.
Yay!
Real good stuff. She breathing? I don't know. You still
they
rolling?
They didn't even care.
No. That was the best part. Still ahead, meltdowns are forever on the internet.
Yay! One person's wedlock goes very wrong. Features a young woman's frustration at our inability to find a boyfriend.
Yeah.
Now, we've all been there,
sure.
Even Kevin, but she takes it someplace you should never go, especially when you're on camera.
Yeah. Here's how not to get a boyfriend, or any friend for that matter.
Yeah.
You like me now? Oh, you like me now? Oh. Do you guys like me now? Can you bring me out? Bring me out off my space pig. What's 2 + 2? Gonorrhea. I want a good time because I like to drink. They don't like me milk. Am I beautiful enough for you?
Girl now.
Yeah.
I mean, she's crazy. Don't get me wrong, but that's awesome.
She's not crazy, Kevin. She's just young and confused, which is why I recorded a special It Gets Better message to give her some advice during this tough time.
Oh.
Hey, Alex. Candace Bailey here. We saw your video online, and listen, we need to talk. I know life is tough for you right now. You think that all boys are jerks, but trust me, it gets better. Eventually, you're going to find someone who's going to like you for you and all of your, web-based enthusiasm. And then eventually, he's gonna get bored, and you'll have to keep his attention with a little bit of makeup, maybe? Oh, I'm so pretty! Oh my gosh, look at me with all my makeup! Oh my gosh, do you like me now? Am I pretty enough for you? Oh, what about now? What about now? you'll have to step that up with some sandwiches. And look, I've got egg salad sandwiches right here. Oh, look, I made them all for you. And rubbing them on my boobies. And they're new boobies. They're big boobies, not like the ones I had before. Do you like me now? Do you like me now? And then you have to compete with this stupid new car. Even though when you met him, he was driving a 17-year-old Civic. Oh, yes, look at me dousing myself with car oil. Do you like me now? Oh, I can pick, I can pick. Oh, yeah, do you like me now? Do you? Woo, yeah. The 4x squared to the factor of 10 is, who cares? I'll get drunk. Woo, yeah. Do you like me now? And a turkey leg. Woo, yeah.
I like the part with the egg salad. I thought that was kind of cool.
Yeah, I got a little overexcited.
You look like one of the ghost twins from the Matrix movie at the end there. There's a little of that and Bizarro Ronald McDonald. It was very nice.
I look like a clown.
Well, that was very nice of you to help her out. You should
Thanks.
Help Darfur with a video next. I think that'd be very, very sweet.
Sure. I didn't help her, but I can help anyone looking to buy a cell phone because it's time for prawn.
Oh, okay.
While tablets and phones get larger and larger, HP is going the opposite way with the Veer. It's one of the smallest smartphones ever at only 2.2 inches wide, and that's including a slide-out keyboard. Plus, it's powered by WebOS, so things like multitasking and flash-enabled browsing are fluid and fast. 4G connectivity and 5-megapixel camera are also included for free with the contract.
Welcome back, Chris Hardwick!
I loved your video.
Do you like me now?
I have three words for you. Why so serious? That was awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, Candace Bailey.
But we're here to talk about the Veer, Chris Hardwick.
All right, it's cute.
Look, it's so little, it's so small, it's almost half the size of a normal smartphone like the iPhone.
Whoa. Yeah, there
Look
it
at
is.
That. Look how
I mean,
tiny.
It's a little bit thicker, but it is really, really, really small. It'll fit. I don't know who this is for.
It's like in the Austin Powers movie. When he pulls out his tiny phone, like, it's like a
little. Like in vitro texting for fetuses. I don't know. And it has this weird headphone adapter because they built it and there was no headphone adapter. I don't know if all the designers are like, hey, what? Oh, I thought you put on the, crap! So they added this little thing that you have to stick on the side, and then it creates that, which is gonna slide, and it's magnetized, so it's gonna pop off.
You have to keep it with you at all times.
Pretty slick workaround there, you guys. Pretty slick workaround.
Now, aside from that, is the screen too small?
I personally think it is. I mean, I don't think this phone is necessarily for me. It might be for teens or kids or meerkats. I don't know who it's for, but it's a
tiny. Anyone who likes really small things.
It's really tiny. I mean, like, you have to squint. I have to squint to see. Tapping and scrolling and multi-touch do work pretty well. That's just as good as on an iOS device. But you're going to have to scroll around to see stuff since the screen real estate is so limited.
Now, obviously, the keyboard is really, really small, too. Are we having just the same problems?
I mean, pretty much. You know, you really have to use the tips of your fingers right there. But I will say that even though it's the smallest we've used, to HP's credit, you can still type on it without making too many mistakes, but you really have to pay attention to what you're doing, which is really tough when you're trying to drive. Overall...
Chris!
What? Oh, my God,
driving.
I'm so sorry! I didn't mean to kill all those
people.
Oprah's
going to be so angry at you.
Overall, you'll be able to use this phone with less problems than you actually think, so...
Now, can this keep up with the iPhone and the Evo?
Yeah, almost. I mean, okay. It's a little bit slower than when loading web pages than the Evo or the iPhone, but it does have Adobe Flash capabilities, so there's that. And, of course, it has WebOS multitasking apps launch in different cards, and then you can cycle through those cards and keep them up in the background. I mean, it's a gorgeous UI. It's easily one of our favorite parts of the phone.
Mm-hmm. Now, how's the camera?
It's not terrible. The picture quality is surprisingly good. There's actually no camera flash, so anything in low light is going to look...
They
didn't put a headphone jack on it. Listen, I don't know. Clearly, they have planned this. They have planned this, but I mean, there's just no room.
It's really dark. Now, have they added any more apps to their app store?
No, why? You know why? The apps aren't going to catch on. Who cares? HP Store is struggling at best, so do not expect to find too much in the way of any kind of killer apps.
Okay, well, at least it has 4G connection.
Yes, yes. I mean, yay, we have not seen very fast speeds on AT&T yet. About 1.5 megabits download and half of that for upload.
You are really selling this right now.
I'm sorry, I feel like I'm just crapping on every kind of good, positive thing you try to do. Just like in my normal relationships. Just like in my normal relationships.
Yes.
What? I just got real for a second.
It's okay. It's okay.
Do you like me now?
Now it's only one cent with a contract on Amazon.
It's powder. I'm putting powder on my face. I know what this looks like. I'm putting powder on my face.
Powder.
Powder.
Uh-huh. It was flour. Actually.
The guy from the movie Powder.
Now, this is only one cent with a contract on Amazon Wireless. What's our rating?
I'm going to give it a 2 out of 5. I know. We kind of... Oh, wait a minute. I like... Let's give that a 2 out of 5. Yes. We like... I'm talking about the phone now. We liked the tiny design, but I mean, other stuff here you could not fit in your pocket, I'm just saying. Although the phone does feel like it's behind the curve with all the new smartphones coming out. We'd recommend the HTC Inspire, or maybe the Motorola Atrix if you want an AT&T 4G smartphone. Maybe go that route.
Yeah, I mean, it's cute, but I think it's more for like a child.
Yeah, yeah, like a kid.
Child-sized fingers.
A baby, or if you have a small little clutch purse.
Give it to your baby.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for today's Gadget Prom. But if you have a gadget you'd like to see us rate, email us at gadgetprom@g4tv.com.
I'm going out of the basement.
Now over to Kevin.
Oh, that's where her basement is? Still ahead in the feed, Sarah Underwood slips into something more comfortable to tell us about EA's massive acquisition. Oh, all right, I'll acquire that. And Jessica Chobot continues playing with Microsoft's coolest toys, including a Kinect that can fly a helicopter. And later, alien fighting Sarah Sangwin Carter from Falling Skies is here live, so stick around.
Here's a question for you. Would you become illiterate for the car of your choice? You logged on to G4TV.com and told us what you thought. We'll have the results after the break.
Web Tools. That's a show about dudes on the internet, right?
Here is Web Tools. Here is Web Tools.
The results are in, and about 81% of you said you would become illiterate for the car of your choice. Good luck with that whole reading street signs thing. Log on to G4TV.com for more questions like this and tell us just how far you go. Seriously, guys, 81% of you? Disappointed. I am disappointed.
It's an internet poll, Candace.
I am really upset about this.
It's time now for some news with Sarah Underwood.
Or Catwoman, if you're nasty. Whoa.
Whoa. Oh. Wait.
What?
It's a laser pointer.
It's time to start the feed.
All the news you need to know.
It's Wednesday, July 16th, and here are your top stories. Electronic Arts is buying PopCap games for the price of, wait for it, $1.3 billion. That means the publisher of everything from The Sims to the Madden franchise will soon reign over the developers of games like Plants vs. Zombies and Bejeweled. EA says they're trying to increase their presence in social and casual gaming and compete with rising powerhouses like Zynga. Good news, when you decide to sue somebody for the time you've wasted playing video games, you'll only have to sue one company. Bad news, you'll lose. Next story. iPhone users are commonly seen as relatively intelligent people, but it turns out some people with iPhones aren't really the brightest crayons in the box. According to a recent survey, just over a third of iPhone users incorrectly believe they have 4G service. Why? Well, evidently, some people think the 4 in iPhone 4 means 4G. The survey also concluded that a large portion of consumers just don't want or understand the difference between 3G, 4G, or LTE service, which means more bandwidth for the rest of us, suckers. Apple has pulled the plug on an app just because it stars a dancing pedo bear. Yeah, the smoking gun recently questioned the nature of the free app Dancing Cuddle Bear, which had the infamous web mascot of pedophilia dancing to a small selection of hip-hop tracks. Word quickly spread about the questionable character's starring role, and I guess that was enough to piss off Steve Jobs and company. Let this be a warning, app developers. Take your filthy, cuddly dancing animals to Android.
Yeah. Do the whip thing, you please. Yeah. Yeah, one more. All right, I'm good.
All right. And finally, in the mood for solving mysteries with some ass kicking in between?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Well, lucky for you, the first trailer for Sherlock Holmes, A Game of Shadows, just hit the web. It's got sexy fortune tellers, fights, explosions, and oh yeah, Robert Downey Jr. in drag.
Please sit. Put your money on the table. Welcome. The cards can illuminate your future. I have a feeling you're in danger.
Actually, I prefer to read your fortune. I see your next client is here to kill you. Oh, how I've missed you, Holmes. I see your web of conspiracy has expanded. I'm knee-deep in the single most important case of my career. The clues point in one direction.
Professor James Moriarty.
Are you sure you want to play this game? I'm afraid you'd lose. I agree, it's not my best disguise, but I had to make do. Didn't see this in the cards, did you? What are we doing down here? We are waiting.
Make it count.
I'm on my honeymoon.
My face.
It's not in your face, it's in my hand.
Get what's in your hand out of my face.
Yeah! A Game of Shadows hits theaters December 16th. I'm Sarah Underwood and you've just been fed. Now back to Kevin and Candace.
You're not gonna whip it again?
Man,
what? I thought you were gonna whip it again. Yeah. That was a close one.
Gotta ribble it. All right. Let's decipher the Twitter wall, shall we?
All right. The Corey Dorsey, Candace Bailey 5. How did you do that in a single take?
Yeah.
Well, we practiced it a couple times before, and then, you know, once we got to the lipstick point, I just had to keep going, no matter what. So.
You've been practicing that in your dressing room since you started in January. Every day before the show, I hear it, do you like me now? And then you hear the punching the mirror. We've had to replace it like 300 times. It's pretty incredible.
Kevin, you weren't supposed to tell anybody.
I'm sorry. Fourth wall shattered. Dr. Sidesteppin' says, if you can tell a straight live TV, how long until I can tell a straight real life?
Ooh, that would be cool.
Yeah?
How long?
Check your local and state laws. If salvia is legal, you could do it tomorrow. Just burn it hot, water filter it, hold it in until your vision starts to vibrate. You're good to go.
All right. Sometimes we give away free stuff for tweets. This is one of those times.
Yes, you're getting a pair of these bad boys, Oakley Transformers 3D glasses.
Oh, you look so good in those.
That's my 3D face. They're real D certified, so you can wear these instead of the smudged up dorky ones that give out at the theater.
Yeah. These are really cool. If you want to be a part of the show and end up on our Twitter wall, tweet us at AOTS or use the hashtag #HeyStop AOTS. Stay tuned. Sarah Sangwin Carter from Falling Skies will be here live.
I love her. I'm not going to lie. Good. I love her. That's in fact, awesome. She's my new wife. Congratulations, Sarah Sangwin Pereira. Coming up next, live, tagging the show, aliens and questions, and me and my wife. You'll see.
On Tuesday, Attack of the Show will honor the life of Ryan Dunn with a special tribute, which will be followed by the return of G4's Proving Ground at 8. Both the Attack of the Show tribute and the return of Proving Ground are our way of celebrating the life and memory of Ryan Dunn. Go to g4tv.com/provingground for more, and we'll be right back.
Fail. Major fail. Fail. Fail, 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 fail. You lose.
You know, alien apocalypses, they're not all that fun. Although they are kind of fun when you get to watch hot girls shoot guns. So I'm all right with that.
Sorry. It's not easy.
Yeah, I never said it was. At least not the first time. Yeah, just imagine that some, you know, someone or something is coming at you. Imagine that someone you love is a...
There you go.
It's not bad, right? Okay, do it again.
I never liked guns.
Neither did I. And after a couple of months, it's as comfortable as a credit card.
Joining me now, Sarah Sangwin Carter, everybody! Will you please go to the gun range with me?
Yes!
Done. Yeah. Interview's over. Good night, everybody.
When are we going to go to the gun range?
As soon as possible.
I take these things seriously.
Okay. What, guns or...
Yes.
Okay.
But also, is that a date? What is that?
Well, Sarah, I don't like to put labels on... Yes.
Is it?
Yes, it is. It's absolutely a date.
I'm single.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
My wife just died. I just heard it right now. It's tragic. That was the improper reaction.
Are you really married?
No, not for you.
I'm confused.
That's my goal. I just live in just a. Thinking about my love life, it should look like cartoon characters just got in a brawl, and there's just a big gray cloud and an occasional shoe or arm
that.
Going anywhere. Yeah, that's all it is.
I
would gladly take you to the gun range, and we'll bring some cameras there, and we'll shoot at or around each other. But you seem so precious and gentle. Like I want to put you on a pedestal and just admire you from a distance. I don't want to get you near a firearm.
That's sweet. I'm good with guns, though.
That's hot. Were you good with guns before Falling Skies?
Actually, yes. And the gun master, we called him, I called him, was actually the same guy who taught me how to shoot for skinwalkers.
Oh, okay.
So the first time that I actually shot a gun was with him, and I cried. Yes.
What was his response? To hit you with the butt of a gun? To like...
No.
Was he nurturing?
He was quite concerned. But he actually tells this story when he teaches celebrities how to shoot guns. He talks about this girl who cried the first time she shot a gun. But the second time I shot the gun with him, I actually did very well. It came like this far away from the bullseye.
Did you cackle maniacally and then start shooting into the air to prove that you dominated the gun?
It was this sort of bizarre experience of, why am I good at that, you know?
Don't question it, just go with it.
Yeah, and I did. Anyway, how cute is Moon with the gun?
Very
in
cute.
In that scene, I know.
Yeah. Dare I say
and
adorable. But you're, and your character
she
on screen...
She was on last week, right?
Well, was she on last week? It might have been a repeat last week. She was on a few weeks ago.
Okay.
Yeah. She shot up the green room. We had to go dark for a little
She's
while.
She's kind of crazy.
You girls and your guns. Your character's also covered with ink. Like
yes.
Mad.
She is fully tatted out.
Yeah. You have any tats that you're concealing? I mean, we'll find out at the gun range, I know. But what about
you're making this date very exciting.
Thank you. Thank you. I set the bar high so I can completely underwhelm you when we're out there. I would have no idea how to talk to you if these cameras weren't on. Not going to lie. Just fetal position and crying on my own genitals.
True. It's not
absolutely true.
The tattoos.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we'll go back there.
Yeah, great. No, please. Conduct.
Yes.
So, why do you have any ink on you, or?
No.
No. But what about your character's
tattoos?
But
my character is covered in ink, and there's a story for every tattoo. I actually spent a while designing the tattoos and coming up with the reason for where and what they are. So I sketched all these tattoos, terrible sketches, not terrible, but then Steve Newborn made them quite fabulous.
So this wasn't like the writers said, okay, your characters need this. You created this whole sort of ink-based backstory for your character.
Yes, with the support of Greg Beeman, thank God, because it's quite a big deal to ask, you know, TNT to actually support any length of time, any added time to the shooting of the show. So I was surprised that they were into Margaret having tattoos. But yeah, she's got Kali and Black Dahlia and...
And then a frog with a sombrero and a bottle of tequila on the small of her back. Does she have that one?
On her back, she's got a giant phoenix rising.
That's cooler than the frog with a sombrero. Is it just like an airbrushing from head to toe before you go out on set then to put all the ink on you?
Airbrushing? That would be wild airbrushing. Like,
yeah, just cover you in a big stencil with cutouts and then just spray you down with ink.
They're stick-on. Stick on tattoos.
Oh, really? Some art department person
that.
Just licking them and slapping it there.
They're real tattoos. I have a giant phoenix on my back right now.
Yes, I can tell. We're so out of time, but I want you to
We are. This is my new album.
I know. Please, that's what I want. I want you to plug. Please, plug the hell out of it.
It's in this cheap little plastic case. It's Sanguine Drake, and it's hot off the press.
That's good. That convention works. Where can they hear the songs and how can they get behind the album?
You can hear the songs online, Google Sanguine Drake, and you can go to Brand New Truth is our best video. It's on YouTube, but this is all, it'll be out in 2 months, so we'll keep you posted.
Love it. Sarah Sanguine Carter, everybody, from Falling Skies. Sarah, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Me too.
I can't wait to shoot guns with you.
Are we going to the gunners?
You're
so full of...
So full of hopes and dreams and wishes. Now Jessica Chobot is doing something at Microsoft. Watch that.
I'm still waiting for Microsoft to open so I can get my exclusive Microsoft campus tour. Waiting for somebody to show up. Open, open, open.
We just launched the Kinect for Windows SDK beta this morning, and we found a whole bunch of really creative, super interesting developers, and we gave them this thing yesterday and said, hey, you got 24 hours. We'd love to see what you can build in 24 hours.
Well, we created a Pong app. We kind of figured that Pong was the first video game, and we figured why not try it out with the newest, best technology. Well, instead of controlling it, you know, with the knob like you might have when it first came out, or a keyboard or a mouse, you control with your hand on the Kinect, and it gives it a little more of a real feel because you're actually controlling the paddle with yourself as opposed to a cursor or a keyboard.
Oh, I didn't think I was going to get it. Dude, that was cheating. All right, so deathmatch, this is it, even though you cheated. Oh, well, look at that, I won. Deathmatch over. Hey, guys, check it out, party favors. Yeah, cute little dingle boppers. I don't care. I'm interested in space blanket. It's a blanket for space. All right, I'll go put it back. One of the coolest things I've seen developed with the SDK is this quadcopter here. Dude, I want to see this thing take off. Yeah, that looks awesome.
We think that the Kinect is a great way to use your body to do controlling physical things. So that's what I think was really interesting about it.
So I've noticed he's using his arms and everything to steer it.
Yes.
So what are some of the different hand signals he's giving?
Exactly. So we have a couple things. One is controlling the elevation.
Uh-huh. And how do you do that?
So basically you just lift your hand or lower your hand.
Okay.
And then we want to give the feeling that you are actually flying.
Okay.
So think of it as raising your arms, and then you fly. So you're controlling pitch and roll and yaw. So think of it like you are the drone, and then you're just controlling it like you are a joystick.
Ah, I didn't even do anything yet. Oh, come on.
come back, come back, come back, come back to me. Come back to me.
We're gonna spin.
Up, get up. No, get up.
I'm not a Jedi. Do you ever just lay out at night staring up at the stars and wonder if there's somebody out there that's staring at the same star that you are?
You talking to me?
Yeah. Fine.
So this is the Worldwide Telescope. So you're looking at an image of the night sky. That's the largest digital image of the night sky ever sent in. It's a trillion pixel image. And then when you have a trillion pixel image, you can sort of look at this. Here's a fuzzy spot here. We can zoom right into it and go into the center of the galaxy.
So where do the images come from?
There's telescopes all over the planet, and they all provide images and data that we end up rendering here in Worldwide Telescope. You've seen this constellation before. Mm-hmm. It's called Orion. And notice when we pull away from Orion, the stars are distorting. The reason they're distorting is because each of those stars in Orion is at a different distance. So when we pull away, you can see how that shape changes. And if we exit the Milky Way, so the Milky Way is about 100,000 light years. This is a new image from the Spitzer that shows what we think the galaxy looks like. But if we continue to pull away from there, we end up seeing the large-scale structure of the universe. Each one of these dots here is a galaxy with 300 billion stars. Let's try and drive this with a Kinect. What do you think?
Yes, please.
Let's do it. So we hooked up Worldwide Telescope to the Kinect, where you can drive through the universe with your fingertips.
Okay.
So how'd you like to take the helm?
I would love to, Captain.
Take us out.
Oh, okay. That concludes my private tour of Microsoft's campus. Sex bots, genetic enhancements, the fountain of youth, not here. However, I highly suspect that there's a Yeti in Building D.
Kick back and relax. It's almost time for a game break.
Ooh, goody! Yay! Dr. Adam Sessler will be here next, so stick around.
And now, a hot chick guesses the capital of Indiana.
Indianapolis?
Coming up tomorrow on an all-new Attack of the Show, indie rockers The Deer Hunter hits our stage with a musical performance. Then Grace Helbig crosses wands with the Harry Potter kids and tries to impress them with some bad magic tricks. And we rate the new home theater PC from Dell in Gadgetron. This 8x8-inch box makes it easy to stream media or record TV for only $300. See it tomorrow.
All right, kids, get out your internet dollars. We got a bumper crop of downloadable content today in Game Break. X-Play's Adam Sessler, everybody. Would you like to go to a gun range with me, Adam?
What does that mean?
Sorry, it was last block. I'm sorry. This is a slow period for games right now, but there's always plenty of downloadable content and cheap games, which is always good.
Yes, you're still thinking about a gun range? I will go to a gun range with you. Right? Right?
Yes, that was the right answer.
Okay.
First up, we have Tick Part 1 from Red Candy Games. 2D platformer.
Yay.
The tried and true character design, I get it. How many times have we played the unicycle with a drill for a hand and a propeller?
I know.
I mean, another one.
It's Vector Man all over again. what's so nice about downloadable games is A, you get the 2D platformers, but you also get all the whimsy that you will not get in Mass Effect. You will not get a Resistance in all those games out there. It really is that kind of charming, fun, and challenging 2D platform.
Yeah, it's too risky to put this in a $60 game, but as a $3 downloadable, there you go.
I mean, yeah, and once again, you can just tell by looking at it, it's a good deal for $3. You're not getting just some wireframe graphics and just, hey, it's over.
So fun 2D platforming, interesting styles of gameplay. It's $3. Go check that one out. But next, there's Lair of the Evil Doer from Going Loud Studios.
See, I just like this name. See, once again, back to the whimsy, Lair of the Evil Doer. I know what I'm getting here. It probably has a lair and a bad guy.
Yes, he's an evil doer as well. And it's a top-down sort of zombie shooter, I guess. Is there a premise here other than Evildoer with a lair?
I mean, you're trying to get through. You're fighting your zombies. I mean, it's very familiar. What's nice is when you read the description, top-down zombie shooter, it's like, I've been here before.
Right.
Once again, once you take a look at it, you have a more humorous take on what has been it's getting to be a rather tired genre.
And I think a cool selling point here is that the levels are procedurally generated. So each playthrough, you never know what you're going to get. It's going to be a different dungeon with different loot, et cetera.
And once again, that's replayability and cheap replayability.
Three chapters for $3, probably worth a download, right?
Yeah, exactly.
All right, now.
I think the important thing is I believe this and Tick, if you want to look for it on your Xbox, look in the indie game section. Don't try to go to the usual arcade section.
Yes, I have that exact problem.
It's an easy problem to make.
And be careful when you're in that indie section, by the way. Just be very careful.
It's like going to the back of the video store sometimes.
Yes, it is. Finally, the latest L.A. Noire DLC was released yesterday. It's entitled Reefer Madness.
What could it be about?
what is going on in this case, Adam?
It's like they're diving underwater and they're trying to save this natural coral. No, it's not. It's about pot.
right.
Obviously, it takes place during the Vice section, which is, I believe, the fourth section in L.A. Noire. It was actually my favorite, and it has to deal with marijuana dealing, some stuff coming from Tijuana. I mean, it's a nice addition to the game, and I think it's one that I would have liked to have actually seen in the original release, because it would have broken up like the heavy-handed like heroin stuff that was happening in that section.
A couple bucks though for only what is rumored to be 45 minutes to an hour of gameplay. Can you recommend that?
I mean, I love that game so much, and I think if you've had the reaction to the game that I did, that completist sentiment is going to force you to get it. If you've been on the fence about the game, or like you play it, you're like, I don't know, I don't think this is going to suddenly tip the scales in your favor. Like, oh, Reefer Madness just sold
right.
it for me.
No, right. No, so, you know, Rockstar did offer one deal where you paid a couple bucks and you got all the DLC for free. At this point, is this something that gamers should invest in, or should they wait and see what kind of DLC is going to trickle out?
I think it's fair to assume that the quality that you're seeing in Reefer Madness is what you can expect from the future stuff. But once again, don't go into this thinking it's going to change your game experience.
Right.
If you liked what you got, go with it, because I think it's one of the best games of the year. But if you disagree with me, as many people do, don't.
Well, no, either way, they need to applaud you, because your ex-play is Adam Sessler.
Yes, I am.
Thank you for coming here for Game Break, Adam.
I am.
Hang out. Let's do a big family photo. Let's just end this thing out.
All right, let's
just close the show. I want to thank Sarah Sangwin Carter. I want to thank Chris Lady Killer Hardwick, Jessica Longshanks Chobot, Adam Horatio Sessler.
Horatio?
All right.
That's your name.
And Sarah Underwood Smith. Thank you guys for watching, and have a great night.